Yeah, Pembroke Corgi, W. Corgi's life. Who the hell is that guy? Why am I getting notifications about it?
Hey everybody, it's Pembroke W. Corgi, and I'm here with...
Mew Bunny.
And we're playing Castlevania 1, the original, the starter of the series, the first time where we get to see a Belmont kill Dracula, or except since I'm playing probably a Belmont dying a lot and not defeating Dracula. Because I have never beat this game. I have tried ever since I was a small child, and I still can't beat this game. So, I'm going to give it... I'm going to give it a try. Because I want to beat this game. I beat Ninja Gaiden! And if I can beat Ninja Gaiden, I should be able to beat Castlevania. So... And where the fuck's the music? No, seriously, where's the music? What the fuck? Where is the music?! What the heck is going on with my Castlevania? Where's the vampire killer? That's like my favorite saw. Is this corrupted?
Have we gone to many levels?
I am honest, 100% confused by why there's no music right now. I'm very confused.
Don't worry about it too much. Sypha just borrowed it.
Even the music is scared.
Right, I still feel for Alucard season 3 with that one scene.
I still haven't watched season 3 yet. It's good stuff, though.
Yeah.
I've heard they take advantage of their mature rating in season 3.
Oh, yes. Our thought process on it was, can we just skip over this and get back to the story? Drax is like, all the advantage in season 3.
I mean, I guess if you can. Oh, dang it. I should have kept the holy water.
Yeah, if only the watch it took us back in time instead of, you know, freezing time.
Well, the watch becomes, like, pretty much useless after the first couple levels, so... I mean, in the first level, you can at least still use it on the boss. But, I mean, still, it takes way more hearts than anything else, too, so... I don't know. Verdant's talking about how he's looking forward to the new He-Man series. I've got... mixed feelings on this new He-Man series. The fact that they're saying it's going to be where the 80s series left off, you know, just gives question marks to me, because it's like there's no place to really go after that. It wasn't like over, but it's like, I don't know, just doing what the 80s did doesn't feel like a great idea, because the thing that makes the 80s one good is, in my opinion, the 80s one is good because it's fun and campy, but camp is something that you can't really do on purpose, usually. It's usually something you do by accident. When you try to purposely be campy, you end up getting stuff that's usually just awful. So I'm looking forward to it. I want to see what they do with it, but I'm concerned about the whole where the 80s left off thing, because it, I don't know, it's not the 80s anymore, so... Mm-hmm. I like a lot of 80s stuff, but I just... I don't know. I'm concerned. Yeah, I agree, Vernon. I would prefer more a continuation of the 2002 series, because that one was really good. That was, like, a good update. It was like the original, but modern. And it didn't feel... It felt like what more, I think, reboot should be like. But, yeah. So, yeah, I'm not sure what to think about this new series. The fact that it's being headed by Kevin Smith, I'm also not very sure of. Because... I mean, I liked a lot of Kevin Smith's old movies, but a lot of his newer stuff has been, I don't know, less good. And I don't know. I don't know what to expect from him for this. I don't know. It could be good. It could be bad. I'm just skeptical, I guess is the best way to put it.
Yeah.
I like Hordak on Modern She-Ra. I mean, he seemed like a legit boss, a legit villain, and not a joke. So, I that was nice. I don't know. Granted, I like new She-Ra, so what do I know?
I mean, I do too. I was just saying, we've got the new She-Ra. Why couldn't it be, the Eternia version of that?
Yeah. Well, that just gets more questions I have, is because, like, if this is supposed to be where the 80s series left off, then what the heck about She-Ra then? Because, I mean, the 80s series ended with, like, She-Ra and, He-Man being, well aware of each other and visiting each other's shows. So, is it still going to have 80s She-Ra in it? I don't know.
Apparently Medusa took, a page out of that one boss from Altered Beast and learned to fly. Just throw her head infinitely and have it fly.
Oh, you mean Neff? Because all the bosses in Altered Beast is Neff. It's the same guy turning into different
like
things.
The first one where he just repeatedly throws his head at you.
Oh, shit! Shit, shit, shit! Lost my double boomerangs. See.
Pim, you're kind of bad about just getting whatever's in the candle without looking.
Yeah, I know. I am. I've always been bad about that. I used to remember where everything was in this game, though. Hi, Tracy!
Hi, Sheepy. Wait, so we have a sheep in the chat. Does that mean I need to start counting sheep?
No, because then you'll fall asleep.
I hope not.
Okay, holy water. I can deal with holy water.
I already been teased about that again.
I wouldn't have teased you if it wasn't for the fact that you actually literally started snoring in the stream at one point. Verdant is talking about he didn't think the art style for new She-Ra was very appealing. I'm perfectly fine with the art style for new She-Ra just because everybody at least look like they have a different body type and look like different people instead of like, as much as I like original She-Ra, everybody has the exact same body. Everybody looks like the exact same person with like a different face. So I prefer having people of different body frames. I think that's, I got my boomerang back. I think that's nice. Especially like, what's her face? What, Scorpia or whatever her name was? Like, she's fucking huge. She's like buff. She's buff and likes to give out hugs. I love it.
She just wants to love people.
Yep.
And follow orders. Mind you, she doesn't seem keen on following all of them. Especially most of Catra's. I can't blame her since Catra's pretty much gone insane.
Yeah. Medusa be dead, yo! But anyways, yeah, new He-Man hopefully is good. I look forward to it. I'm just like I said, things make me curious. But I mean, heck, they did announce that Mark Hamill is going to be like Skeletor, so that should be interesting. I mean, if there's anybody who can ham up Skeletor other than, you know, Alan Oppenheimer, it's definitely going to be Mark Hamill, so.
Yeah, Mark's a good voice actor. I tell you, Moneybag should have killed that crow after it fell on it. But not gonna use the excuse, exclamation, Jeezum Crow!
Jeezum Crow! All these crows, Jeezum Crow! Oh, Castlevania's always had catchy music. Oh, hey, the music's back.
I like that. Castlevania's always had catchy music. Oh, hey, the music's back.
I kind of zoned out after, like, the first level for whatever reason didn't want to play music.
I don't even have volume, so I can't tell you.
And Vernon, you're going to question a She-Ra cartoon about, like, consistency? Did you ever watch the original? Nothing's consistent in a Filmation show. Even being inconsistent in the new show is more consistent than anything Filmation makes.
Well, you know, I was going to say, you know, except Lou Schumer being, you know, Lou Schumer.
Lou Schumer being crap.
Yeah.
Yeah, fuck it.
Not just being crap, but, you know, cheaping out and going, oh, I'm just going to use my family as voice actors.
Yeah. Like the later half of the Tom and Jerry comedy show. The later half of the Tom and Jerry comedy show is just Lou Schumer and his family as voice actors, because there was a voice actor strike and Frank Welker was in part of the strike. So for the latter half, they didn't have Frank Welker being the only voice actor. So it's all Lou Schumer and his family doing all the voices, and it's terrible. Is really bad.
I mean, you know, worse than the Droopy I had to watch.
Well, that's with Frank. Imagine what it's like when Frank's not there. That's all I have to say. Imagine, like, Lou Schumer is Droopy and the wolf and everything. It's pretty bad. But of course, Frank Welker still gets the credit for some reason, despite not being in it. That's the best part.
I'm sure he wishes he didn't.
I wonder if he still got paid for that.
Well, that's something we can ask him next time we see him somewhere.
Frank?
Mm-hmm.
I've never met Frank Welker. I'd love to, though. He doesn't do very many conventions as a thing. But probably because he's always in something. I think he did one, like, I know he did one, excuse me, I think he did one BotCon. I'd love to meet Frank Welker. I mean, I didn't get to meet Don Messick before he died, so Frank Welker's probably the second, like, best voice actor I could possibly meet. I have met, I did meet Maurice LaMarche and Lisa Ortiz, which is cool. Back when she was voicing Amy Rose.
Yeah.
It's like one of the few good things that happened at like the terrible Sonic Con convention that I was at. It was cool, though. She said that she really liked playing Amy. She's like, I love her. She is so cute.
I mean, really, whose story is chicken and, you know, just random bricks in a castle, old castle, that, you know, disappears, that it gets destroyed every few thousand years? Knife. At least it's not the watch.
Yeah. Pretty much. The knife's terrible, but... Yeah, this is the game where getting the knife is not what you want to do. Castlevania... I mean, Ghosts and Goblins, get the knife. Friday the 13th, get the knife. Castlevania, no, you don't want the knife. Fucking damn it!
Did you get the watch again?
Yeah. I should be giving you the direct camera, shouldn't I?
I don't mind either way.
Yeah. I'll give you the direct so you can. There you go. Should be having that now.
Yep.
Oh! Fucking fish man. Fucking bat! Yes! Holy water! Give me that holy water. See ya, fish man.
That's so holy about it. Oh, you see, it's got these holes in the bottle.
The ball was bottle wasn't made by very good craftsmen.
Yeah, for some reason, these priests kept kids around. I'm not sure what that was all about.
No, these fishmen are not unusually attractive, Verdant. Nice reference, though.
Damn, Fleeman.
Fucking...
Where's the bug spray when you need it?
Igor motherfuckers. Ah! God damn it. Oh, my first death. Da-da-da. Da-da-da. Ooh, extra life. Oh, take that. I forgot you can get extra lives by score in this game. I forgot this game had score. Wait, how could I forget that? I was purposely getting all the treasure items. I think it's just I don't pay attention to score very much. Video games. Even, like, arcade games, I don't, like... really pay attention to that, and that's kind of like the point of arcade games. Come on down here, bitch. Oh, fuck! It looks like I was the bitch! looks like it was I who is the bitch. Okay, I got a good rhythm down here. Until then. I'm still doing pretty good. Just keep this up. Be nice if you guys you drop me something, you know, I don't know, useful.
That's crazy talk.
Okay. I don't know why that just took three hits in comparison to last time, but sure, I'll take it.
Maybe one of those game bugs where it still had damage from last time.
I don't know. Like I said, I don't know what caused that, but I will most definitely take it.
Hey, Pam. Hmm. What do you got there?
A knife!
No!
My favorite is still the Pokemon one because the girl going, no! Oh, dang it. It would have been nice if I had the holy water. That works really good against Frankie here.
Well, you know, he technically is a sort of undead abomination.
Ah, damn it. Two more hits was all I needed. Maybe it'd help if I would, like, you know, dodge. Frank, please.
Oh, you mean dodge!
This game needs... Castlevania needs a Dark Souls dodge roll. Wasn't there a rumor of, like, someone trying to get From Software, the makers of Dark Souls, to make a Castlevania game?
I have no idea.
I think I heard that somewhere. I will say that... I will say, if there's anybody that I think can make a 3D Castlevania game that would feel like Castlevania, it'd be them. Because Dark Souls kind of feels like, I don't know, the closest equivalent. It's hard as hell and fun. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Frankie, you are gone!
You know, I don't think it's ever explained. What the hell is this red worm all the bosses drop?
You know, I don't know. Let's see.
Yeah. Hopefully in one of these levels we'll get some mashed potatoes. We're getting really tired of sticking it in the wall.
Technically hearts aren't currency in this, they're ammunition. They're only currency in Castlevania 2. In this they're ammunition, but they are definitely not health.
Stay away. Go away, watch me.
Yeah, for once, I finally, you know, didn't get it. So, keep this holy water for now. Two favorite weapons in this game, holy water and boomerang. Both are very helpful.
I'm on to you, Mr. Game & Watch.
I didn't want to throw.
I'm on to you. I'm on to your bullshit.
Uh-oh.
Yes, we'll use holy water to break you to break the candle to get dark.
Red skeletons now.
What's the comedian got to with Castlevania?
I don't know, but he's unkillable. Oh, shoot. I think there's something...
I only wish I'd found out about that comedian when I was younger. I enjoy his work so much.
I don't think I've seen any of his work, but I know of him because, like, my mom said she liked him a lot, and that's all I kind of know.
Mm-hmm. I didn't know much about him. I'd seen him once on I Love Lucy, and then, you know, I remember my mom told me, you know, she really liked him. I got this DVD that was real cheap with a bunch of his stuff on it. It was one of those double-sided DVDs.
Oh, gosh. I forgot those were a thing.
Yeah.
Come on, bitch. Get over here, you axe... You axe-throwing motherfucker.
Can I please combine the boomerang and the axe to throw it like that?
God, I wish.
Boomerax.
The racks. The boomerax. This isn't Wizards and Warriors, unfortunately, which did have an axe that did that. Mm-hmm. I'm doing a pretty good run at this, I have to say. I haven't had to continue yet, so.
Now you've jinxed it.
Oh no. Well, I am about to fight the Grim Reaper. He is one of the harder bosses. There we go.
Damn it, Pip, you're not supposed to trip on the axes.
Don't axe me again.
I just wanted to axe you a few questions.
Of course, Sunset wouldn't be happy with hearing these puns.
That's why we're making them now.
If he was here now, I'd just be making more puns. Just to punish him.
That's what Drax and I were doing the other day with egg puns. He's not ready to murder us.
I'm the only person. According to him, I'm the only person he allows to say puns. He's like, Pim's a dad. He gets to say dad jokes. Damn it.
But I'm a Toon Rabbit. I'm supposed to be allowed to say these jokes.
No, you're a Toon Rabbit. You're supposed to, like, dress up in drag and, like, con Elmer Fudd out of stuff.
No, I do that with you.
Oh. It's like, what do I say after that? It's like, what can I say after that?
I literally had commissions based around that idea.
I know. It's just like, what does one say after something like that? Nothing. There's nothing you can say after that.
I just take dressing and drag a different way than my father did.
Knew there was something over there. Except this guy's probably going to regenerate. No, he stayed gone. Good. Oh, fuck!
Oh, fuck!
Oh, now this is starting to feel like Castlevania.
I don't know, it just doesn't seem to count in Sunset's eyes.
But this doesn't count as a Castlevania?
No, Drax is like, I'm an older brother, shouldn't that count? I'll be right back.
Alright. Ah, no! I forgot about that. Well, looks like it's time for save states. I'm off to a great start. Off to an excellent start here. scene. Let's see, let's keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. These guys seem to have a bone to pick with me. Don't like that joke? I thought it was pretty humorous. Watch me make a marrow escape!